Hello, folks. Welcome back to a practice session. So, from the previous trip to the casino, you seem to be doing okay and sometimes not so great. Not hitting it all tall, all short at the same time. It's because I lack the ability to hit the snake eye and the midnight, the 12s, the box cut. So, in this section, I'm going to try to practice that so I can easily nail that. So, same thing, we take our dice, and for the whirl and outside number, we set it up for the 6, 4, 5, 6. Okay? So, it's basically it's like a cross six with the 4, 2, and just quarter it down towards you, okay? So, the set is 6, 4, 5, 4 for the horns and whirl. And that's what I have issue with, so I'm gonna practice that and try and nail it. 4, 2, 2. Points four. Yeah, made some good run in the earlier session, but the last session I got beat, gave it all back. It was a disappointment. All the work wasted. So, what do you do when you get beat? You get back in the gym and train harder so you can be better next time. Oh, set it up the wrong way. See? Wanted to do the cross six because of muscle memory. Four, four, eight. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the set. Why is it giving me all the hard ways? Maybe I should be using this for the hard way set next time. Gotta experiment a little bit more with this. It's not designed for the hard way. Five. Yeah, it's just to tell you folks that the set is all dependent on the individual. I know in my hand, if I needed a field number, I can do the 6, 3, 3, 6, and that will give me a lot of it except the 2s and 12s. So I need to find something that can help me pass that hurdle. If I can get the 2 and 12 down, I can nail it. Three. 2, 1. And one of the reasons I was down too was I wasn't really paying attention to the math that much. I was just chasing the all tall and all short. Just lose track of it. Just got carried away. Careless, stupid mistake. Cost money. We're at the fourth row. Should be able to pull our bets down, go back to basic. 12, there you go, okay. It's working what it is. 6, 6. The sweet spots in the 7 is the 8, 9, and 10. So we had 5 row, and I wasn't really paying that much attention to the my SOR. When I got to it's like 10, 11, I just pull all my bets off and just roll. And I miss a lot of good opportunities. I had a couple of good monster roll, and yet I wasted it by not betting. That's what it gets when you get a scared money. Seven out, 2, 4. Five, yep. Seven. Well, at least we did hit 1 12 number. Let's try that again. One more time, okay? Get a dice. Okay, we got to set up for the 6-4, 5-6. Try to get that 2s and 12 out of the way first. Seven out. I got nailed on that a lot too. I loaded up all the bases and everything and went $30 a piece on a $25 table. Then first row came with a seven and knocked it out twice. Bust me down to basic. Same thing. Ah, keep going across six again. Let's try to get that 2 and 12. Six, 12. Okay. 6-6-12. Okay, now let's just go to our field. Another thing you could try is once you get almost all the numbers out for the all tall, all short, let's say you're missing one from the all short and one from the all tall, just lay that number that you're missing if you can. Because the chances are you're gonna crap out before you you get that number. 11. 5-6. Alright, we got all the hard stuff done. Let's see if we get some of the easier numbers. Same thing. 6-3-3-6, my go-to for the field killer. Seven out. Again. Let's try that one more time. Let's see what we can do. Okay, take our dice. We're gonna set up. We're gonna try to knock the 2s and 12 out early. Okay. Gonna use the 6-4, 5-4, 5-6. The world set. Nine's a point. 6-3. Sorry, I flipped that. Here's a 3, I flipped that. 6-9. Okay, try again. Six, 1-5. I don't even know what my SOR is for this set. I haven't thrown this at all. Gonna have to figure out what the SOR is on this set. 10. 6-4. On the third row. Five. Fourth row. 4-1-5. Try switching this way. Let's do the 5-6-6-4. Just reversing the order of the dice and so. Seven out. That's 2-4. 4 rows. So I guess the set for me right now will be under 4 rows SOR. That's about it. Let's keep practicing. See if we got one more. One more hitters. Okay, let's try. try again. Take our dice. We know we got 4 good roll in this set. So let's roll in 4 and then we switch it up. 6, 4, 5, 6 trying to hit the world. We're hoping for the 2 and 12. 9 again. 9.63. Snake eye. 1, 1, 2. Okay, we got that out of the way. That's 2 roll. Let's do 1 more. Come on, 12. 8. 5, 3. So at this particular time for this set, the SOR right now is 5 for it. So we're not pushing it. We're going back to our standby. We're doing the 6, 3, 3, 6 to try to load up the base, the feel. 5. 1, 4. We know we got about 8 SOR in this set. Four. 1, 3. Eight. 2, 6. We're at 6 rows so far. Six. 2, 4. A little too much energy there. Just one of the dice kicked out too hard, too much. That seemed to happen that too at the casino that night. Seems to be too much power landing on a hard table compared to the soft table I'm used to here at home. Three, 2, 1. Made the all short. We're at 8 row. That's the sweet spot where the 7 should show up. It's 8, 9, and 10. So we're going to try to avoid it. We still got to hunt for the feel. We need 10, 11, 12 to make the all tall, all short. Seven out, just like I said. 4, 3. And we roll 8 row, 2, 4, 6, 8 row, hit the all short. And that's it. From now on, I just gotta practice trying to increase my SOR, spend more time in the practice, and practice that 6, 4, 5, 6 set combination that's designed for the world and try to nail the 12 and 2 that give a better odds of hitting all tall or short. That's it, folks. Hope you keep practicing and don't give up. The result will come, okay? Can't beat the game, you don't show up for practice. Take care.